Hi, you're listening to Book Chat with author Vivian E. Moore.
Welcome, everybody, to this week's episode. We really appreciate you joining us. This podcast really shows us how we can all learn, live, and thrive off of each other. By sharing our knowledge through our conversations, we will impart some knowledge whilst learning ourselves how to progress even further. Here is your host.
Hello and welcome to Book Chat. I am your host, author Vivian E. Moore. I hope everyone had a great week. I hope you're having a great weekend. We are on the countdown for Christmas, so I hope that you have got the majority of your Christmas shopping done. I just finished mine completely today, having wrapped the present. There's nothing under the tree. The tree is up, but there is nothing under it at the moment. But I'm working on that. So Christmas is next Friday, so I have from now until Friday to get that done. And I have quite a bit to get done, but I'm looking forward to it. I'm excited about Christmas, and I hope you are too. And I hope you're excited about today's show. So without further delay, we're going to get straight to it. All right. So the title of today's show is 12 Days of Publishing, and the topic is 12 Steps of Publishing. So this show, I just want to share with you how this show came about. Well, I got a message from one of my Facebook friends, and they wanted to know, how do you go about publishing? So they wanted to know how to publish poetry, but publishing is publishing. You know, whether you're publishing a manuscript or, you know, you're publishing a book of poetry. So basically, that's how this show came to be. So if that person is listening in tonight, I hope they are, so they can get a few details of what to do. Now, I'm not going to go into great detail. And what I'm going to do is share with you from the selfpublishingschool.com how to publish a book. And that is actually, that URL is at https://selfpublishingschool.com/how-to-publish-a-book. All right, so that's that. If you go to that URL, you should be able to find it. So so here's their take on how to publish a book step by step. All right, so number one, they say that you should decide why you want to publish a book. Well, for the most part, most people already know, you know, because they've written it, so they want to publish it. But I guess if you're one of those people that's undecided as to why you want to publish a book, then I guess that first question is for you. All right. So number two is write your book. Well, that's a given. Okay. So I just want you to know that this is actually for beginners. This is how to publish a book for beginners. So if you are someone who is green and you've never even thought about the publishing process, well, then these are the 12 steps for you. Okay. And two, I thought that it would be nice to put it in the form of like the 12 days of Christmas, you know, since it's Christmas and I'm in that spirit. So I wanted to present to you, you know, the 12 steps of publishing. All right. So back to the list. All right. So number three is get feedback before publishing your book. And so that's what my Facebook friend did today, when they messaged me and they wanted to know, about the publishing, industry and how you went about it and all of those things. So, and I gave them the process, the steps of what to do. All right. So number four is choose a book title. All right. Well, for me, the book title always comes first. I mean, that is what gives me the idea of what to publish, or, you know, what my book is going to be about. I'm sorry. And so, you know, what the story is going to consist of by that title. So if you're a first timer, so you want to choose a book title. Okay, so number five is after you've written the book and it's time for editing, you want to make sure that you hire a great book editor. All right, so I want to also give you a step between five and six that they didn't do, which is crucial to any first time publisher or anyone author who is getting ready to publish their work. You want to make sure that you register your work after you've edited it, had it edited, to the Library of Congress. You want to make sure that you do that. First and foremost, before you start shopping that book out to different publishers, you want to make sure that you have protected your work because, you know, you've put a lot of time, days, hours, months, sometimes years into developing stories or, you know, writing your poetry, whatever. And the last thing you want is for someone to try to, you know, to infringe on your work. So make sure that you get your work copywritten. That's crucial. All right. So number six is design a book cover that converts. Well, most apps, add-ins like Kindle from Amazon and Smashwords and Google, they do it for you. All you need to do is upload your book, and they want you to upload it in you know, Microsoft Word or something like that, you know, if that is the software program that you're working on. They want you to upload it in that and, you know, not have any type of templates or things like that. So you want to make sure you go through. And Microsoft has this cool little feature. If you go out to the first page, to the home screen. Okay. That's what I was trying to tell you, to the home screen. And then if you click on, one of your, whichever one you want to edit, you click on it. And so what you do is you go down to info. And so on that screen, so it has the 12 days of publishing. Okay. And so it has protect document, so you can, you know, you can protect it. So, but you may not want to do that if you're going to have it edited, because if it's in protective mode, then they can't edit it. But anyway, you want to inspect the document, and then you want to manage the document. So when you do the inspect document, you're checking for issues. So that way, if you have used a template and it's leaving some of those, you know, those little details behind, you want to make sure you give it a clean sweep, so that way none of that stuff is left there. So it'll be nice and neat when you forward it on through, you know, one of those platforms, whether it's Kindle or Smashwords or Google or, you know, mostly Apple. Well, they converted to EPUB and Kindle e-readers, and, you know, they converted to any style of gadget that you use to read your books. You know, if you're reading it from an iPhone, you know, you can download the Kindle app, or you can just read it from the Apple app that's already on there. So, but anyway, they do the conversions for you, so you don't have to do that. That's one of the great things of what that is if you're self-publishing, or if you are sending your work out to be edited, then they, you know, they'll edit it for you. But if you are going to you know, send it out to publishing companies, and if you should, you know, get a publishing contract, then they'll do all that for you. So you don't have to worry about doing that. But this is mostly for those DIY authors, who want to self-publish. Then you would have to do all that yourself. But, you know, as I just explained, if you use one of those templates, then they will do the conversion for you. You don't have to do that anymore. All right. So number seven is, it says create your Kindle Direct Publishing account. Okay, so we're going to go with Kindle. All right, so of course, you know, that's an Amazon product. So if you're going to do that, you just set it up. You go out there to Kindle Direct Publishing. It's KDP. And you set up your account. And so it'll take you through all the steps. And you can also download their add-in. And it is the Kindle add-in. And so it does everything for you. It sets the book up. You can do these nice little fonts and things of that nature. I mean, it designs it. It does the layout. And you can make the nice little chapter headings and the chapter subtitles. And you can put these little nice embellishments on the chapter, you know, the first chapter of every paragraph. You can do that. What else does it does? You can create the title page, all the elements in between. It does all of that. And so, you know, it does all of that for you. And then you can actually see what it's going to look like before you actually, send it to Kindle. So it takes you through the complete process, and you get to see what the completed book will look like once you finish with all of that. So it's super easy. It really is. But anyway, and two, using, if you go the Kindle route, they have book covers that you can actually use. Now you can upload your own, you can do that yourself. If you've worked with someone, if you want to work with someone who actually does book covers, then you can, once they get it all done for you, then you can upload that into their program, and then it'll put it on all your books for you. So it's a nice little feature, and I really like it. I've used it before. So you might want to check that one out. All right. So number eight is format and upload your book. Well, I just told you, you can eliminate all of those things. It should be, if you're using Word, Microsoft Word, then that's the format you're going to use. And, you can set it up as to, when you go back out to your main screen, you can set it up and, set all your margins and all your fonts and all of these things. And you should keep it simple, because once you load your manuscript into that template, it's going to change the font and the size. So it'll do all that for you. So you don't have to worry about doing that. So, but anyway, number nine is self-publish your book. Okay. So that's a given, but I'm just taking you through the steps, because this is what they say for the 12 steps of publishing. So, this is what you do. If you are green and you've never done it before, then you want to follow this process. All right. So number 10 is you want to price your book. And that's the great thing. That's another great feature with Kindle. You get to price your books, and what you should do is, before you price your book, because you don't want to price the book so high to where, no one's going to buy it, because, you have to realize that this is a very competitive business, selling books. And so if you've overpriced, an ebook, it just might get skipped over, because someone will probably be more inclined to, get an ebook that costs $2.99, $1.99, whatever, so you just want to be practical about your pricing. And a lot of people want to overprice, because they think that if they do that, then they're going to get, bigger royalties. So, don't cut your nose off to spite your face. Don't do that. Because in the long run, that will hurt you. So you want to be practical about it, because, you have to remember that, yes, a lot of people do read ebooks, but two, if they read a lot of ebooks, they don't want to pay a whole lot for them. And another great feature with Kindle is that they have the Kindle Unlimited program. Put your book in that program, and what it is that once you put your book in Kindle Unlimited, it's free for all readers, if they have the Kindle app, or if they have the Kindle tablet, whatever. Anyway, it's free, and you download the book, and the consumer doesn't pay anything for it, but the artist. Now, you still get paid whether they buy the book or not, because they're reading it. And so, and sometimes you can have, oh my gosh, so many people just go out there and read your work, and you get paid for it. You get paid for every word they read and for every page they read. So you're still getting paid, whether you enroll it in the Kindle Unlimited program. You get paid from that, and you also get paid from your book royalties, from the pricing of your book. When you actually sell a book, whether you're selling an ebook or you're selling a physical book, you also get paid for those too. So it's like a win-win-win situation. So, you can't go wrong there. So I love that program. And, I could go more in depth about it, but I have done it in past shows. So if you listen to some of those shows, then you'll hear me talk about that. All right. So number 11 is to form a launch team. Okay. So if you are a self-publisher, 9 out of 10, you probably got a very strict budget. So, you might want to enlist some of your family members or some of your good friends who wouldn't mind helping you out with that. you know, help you formulate everything, you know, get your ideas together, you know, get your planning together, how you want to do the book launch and things of that nature. Because basically that's what that is. When they say form a launch team, they want you to do a book launch. And that's a good idea, you know, to let everyone know before the book actually comes out that you have a book coming out. So that prepares the readers, you know, for your work. And especially if you're new onto the scene, whether it doesn't matter if you're new onto the scene, or if you've been doing it for a while, you still want to alert your readers that you're coming out with the, you know, with the book, so that way they can be prepared for it and, you know, and be ready for it. So, you know, you can blast them on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram, you know, anywhere that you have people who follow you, then you want to make sure that you get that information out to them, to as many people as possible. All right. So number 12 is maximize your book launch exposure. And that's what we were just talking about. So, you know, if you have a low budget, last week I talked about features, free features that you can use to do book launch exposure, and you can do advertisement and all of those things. Even with the Amazon KDP, you can advertise through them too. You know, if you have a very small budget, you just set how much you want to spend for how many days, and then, you know, you advertise that way, and they'll let you do free advertisement as well. And you can also advertise on Facebook. It's not expensive. You set your own budget for how long you want to advertise and who you want, you know, who you want to see the book, who you want to sell the book to. So, you know, it's a long process, you know, it really is. But if you follow the step by step guide, you should be able to do it successfully. And that's what we want you to be. We want you to be successful in the end. All right. So we're all good with the 12 days of publishing. All right. So now that we got all that out of the way, let me make sure I give you some of these URLs, to keep you, you know, to keep you hooked in with my show that comes on weekly at 6 every Saturday, and also some of the other platforms where you can follow me and like me. And of course, the first one is Spreaker. You can like the show, you can follow the show. That is at https://www.spreaker.com/user/AuthorVivianEMoore. You can follow me on Facebook. You can just type in my name, Author Vivian E. Moore, and you'll get that page. And you can follow me, like me, subscribe to my page if you like. You can do the same for Twitter and also Instagram. And Instagram is by invitation only. So, you know, just send me an invitation and I'll get back to you on that. And also, you can check out my website. That is at https://www.authorvivianemoore.com or authorehshepherd.com, and follow my blog. That is at https://vivianemoore@blogspot.com. All right, so we got that out of the way. And now here are all the other platforms where you can listen to Book Chat. You can listen to it every day if you want to, because it is recorded on all these platforms. You can listen to the live version today or on Saturdays at 6, or you can listen to the recorded episodes from day one all the way until today. All right, so you can listen to it, of course, on Spreaker, on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, iHeartRadio, Google Podcasts, CastBox, Deezer, Podcast Addict, Podchaser, YouTube, SoundCloud, and Giles Savin. So those are all the places where you can find Book Chat with Author Vivian E. Moore. You can download the episodes, or you can just listen to them on those platforms. All right, so we're all set on that. Okay, so tomorrow is worship day. And if you are not back in the physical church buildings, I hope that you are still attending service somewhere, whether you're attending it over the phone or over Facebook Live or what other medium that you may be using to make sure that you get the word, that you hear the word. And also, in times like this, we're in the Christmas season, no doubt about it, and Christmas is just a short ways away. But we want to remember, you know, those who are less fortunate, you know, and if you see the Salvation Army ringers out there with the buckets, please feel, you know, just put something in the pot, you know, because there are a lot of people who, due to this pandemic, I mean, they are in real dire straits. And so, you know, I would love for everyone in the world who celebrates Christmas to have, you know, a happy holiday, you know, knowing that, maybe they'll have something under the tree or, you know, or a meal on the table. But two, we have to remember the reason for the season. And having said that, so I want you to reach deep into your hearts and, you know, and remember that, because it's very important. And also to tell people that you love them, because tomorrow is not promised. Today may be the only chance you get to say that. So I love you. I hope you love me back. Until the next time you hear my voice, God bless you and goodbye.
Loved what you've heard on this week's episode? Well, the answer is simple. It would mean the world to us if you could head over to iTunes and leave us a 5-star review and feedback. Spreading the word really is the best way to grow our podcast and achieve even greater things. Thank you.